doing a live tutorial. Hi, Facebook and Instagram at the same time.
Hi, guys.
Christy,
hey,
come
paper
in here.
Floor. Okay.
So I'm Kelly from Molly Jane. This is my twin sister and business partner, Christy.
Hello.
And today we're going to show you how to build a, what size is this? 4 foot by 3 foot?
Oh, I'll actually get the size. I think that's right.
So just in time for Easter, you can do this with any canvas.
This one is actually 36 inches by 40.
Oh, 36 by 40. So it's pretty big. You can see the frame behind us. But we have this beautiful print of Christ, and it's from the Mark Mabry Reflections of Christ collection. And it comes framed or unframed, and Christy voted.
Let's get it.
Let's send it unframed so then we can show you guys how to build your own. So I saw the tutorial originally on our friend Laura from A Turquoise Homes site. The difference is she used the lattice wood, and we're going to actually be using barn wood. If you guys missed my little boy's room reveal, this wood is from Porter Barnwood. It's really beautiful. It's reclaimed wood. And so I think it initially came in like 4 to 5 inch strips. And
yeah, so Corey just, my husband just ripped it down and do it on the table saw to 1 inch strips. So that's what we're going to be framing around the canvas. First, we have to put the canvas on a frame. So but
let me jump in and say, if you're leaving comments, hi.
Oh, I need to put my glasses on because I can't see anything
computer-wise. So if you're leaving comments, the phone and computer are both going at the same time and they're really far away. We will respond back to you when we end. We'll go back through, and after we end, we'll go back through and answer any questions. So please don't think we're ignoring you. We're just only two people trying to do things.
We should have an assistant here. I'm going to see if I grab my glasses real quick.
They're right here. Okay, so the first step is building this beautiful frame.
Wait, where are my glasses?
They're right there, Lori. Christy's father-in-law is from Holland. He's an amazing woodworker. We are capable of building this, but we were out of town last week, and I really wanted to get this done before this Sunday, so if you guys want to order this print, you have time to get it to your houses. And so he generously built this. You can use poplar, you can use pine, which is super cheap over at Home Depot. You can use any kind of wood. I think pine is super affordable.
Yeah, so this is.
And all you do is you get your measurements, which is roughly 2 by 3, and you can just try to get it close to you. Walk over to you.
I was going to show you.
So he actually spliced it, which is, it's gorgeous, and it's the right way to do it. It's a little bit out of our DIY capabilities.
He's got all these really fancy machines. Like a lathe, he actually built this table.
So this frame is actually going underneath the canvas. It's not going to serve any decorative purpose. So you really could just take your 4 strips and brad nail them in the sides, just like we've shown you on our sign tutorials.
Yeah. But it doesn't matter if it's pretty or ugly wood.
Yeah, and yeah, you're right. You can use your cheapest wood because this is going underneath. Yeah. So we laid a drop cloth down because we don't want our frame, our print to be damaged. So let's go ahead and start framing it out. So let's lay our canvas flat. Sorry, I'm trying not to get in front of you.
So this canvas comes with a border. And so my father-in-law, you can see the border on the side. So my father-in-law built the frame to match. So this will wrap perfectly around the frame that he built. So
I'm just going to lay it flat.
We're going to lay it face down. And it can shift from Reflections of Christ in a nice sturdy box. And it does not, it's not wrinkled. So if you wanted to just have the canvas and frame it in a regular frame, you don't do anything crazy to prep for that. Yeah, and it's pretty sturdy. You actually, you can tug on it and it's not going to be very fragile. You can also do the same technique with engineer printing. You can get huge prints done for like $2. And they're like up to 5 feet, I believe, over at Staples.
Yeah.
So those are some ideas for you.
We're just going to check the sides and make sure that they're lined up.
So I think the best way to line it up is to go off of, let's just choose, is this the top or the bottom? Let's choose the top.
Okay.
And we'll just go for the grayscale.
That's what my husband said. You guys should check this ahead of time.
Yeah, we should. You guys know us. We're kind of eyeballers.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go up real high because it's from the bottom.
All right. So we're just eyeballing here. It looks good on this side. How's your side look, Kel?
It's good, but I think I would measure it just to be triple face, at least with.
Yeah.
Well, you want it to be even. The nice thing with this print is it's pretty forgiving because it has so much white.
Yes, and the bottom, like, you can't even hardly tell. So we're good.
All right. So if you've wrapped a canvas before,
It's just like covering furniture.
Yeah,
you just pull real tight and staple. So we have
so
a staple gun.
I'm gonna move this down so you guys can actually see what Kelly's doing.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
So you're just gonna pull,
staple,
pull, staple. So staple gun, you can get these at Walmart, Home Depot, anywhere. I don't even know what brand this is. I've had it for a million years. Arrow Fastener, it says.
I think these are half inch staples.
Yeah, and these are the
they're flat, not
heavy
round.
Duty. Yeah, the flat. So you just pull as the word is actually taut. And I like to do it pretty close to the edge of the frame. And then you just keep going. So if you push it down nice and tight, you want to pull on all staple. Yep. So you want to just get that.
Ah! You are punk. I was like, I so mean.
Okay, so we'll just continue to wrap. Let's do the top and then
I wait, this is when I wish we had the fast forward motion.
We'll go fast.
But now you guys can see if you want to do this on your own, how fast it really goes.
Let's
do the bottom first, and then we'll go with the top.
Slide it back. Okay. We'll do three more down here.
We have some friends over today while we're doing this. Yeah.
And this will be doubly reinforced, the canvas to the wood, as soon as we put the frame on it as well from the wood. So.
Pull.
We'll come up with a step by step tutorial on our blog afterwards. But this is basically it. Let's
are you going to tuck in or go out?
Should we do the middle first real quick?
Yeah.
I believe that's what the pros do.
We're not furniture re.
I'm just going to pull this thing.
We're not furniture with an upholsterer.
We're no Nikki Grandy, folks.
Yeah, Nikki should also.
Okay. Let's do this.
I
just want to tuck it. Wait, you think you're in the way. So what I'm going to do here is just like wrapping a gift. We're going to just tuck it in.
I'm going to pull this down so you can see.
And then we're just going to fold it. Well, you need to get like a nice tight edge.
Yeah. You guys can see on Facebook, but on Instagram, it's a little bit harder to take a look.
What do you think?
This way.
Yeah, we'll just tuck it
I'm
in.
Sure you guys probably have great tips for us, but we can't see you.
There we go. So I just did it like a gift, and I'm just going to. There you go. So you can't see it, but I'll show you in a sec. We'll do the same thing. So I kind of double tucked it. Which kind of gets a little bit bunchy, but it's okay.
It's stapled nice and long.
This reminds me of my mom. So we're one of nine, six and seven, because we're friends. And our mom, every Christmas, hires her neighbor Mallory to wrap all of the grandkids' gifts. Random thought. Okay. So three sides down. One more to go. That edge does get a little bit bulky,
but we don't care because
you're not going to see it. But also, you could snip. A little bit of it off.
We have kids.
Someone say,
Opie, Opie.
Over there.
Alright, I'm gonna get her set up.
Kelly, it's pretty much
it's just me. Let me center myself.
Okay, so the other thing you can do is you can leave this frame just as is if you would like. You don't need to add a second frame. Now, me and Christy have a little bit different style. If it was me, I would have done probably a 4-inch, real thick, heavy barn wood.
Like a barn wood.
And she's going for like a minimalist, simplistic, kind of boho almost look. Very classy.
Our styles are very different, that's for sure.
All right, last one. Moment of truth. Let's see.
Okay, top, bottom, bottom.
Oh, you guys!
It's so cute.
That looks amazing. It looks awesome. So let's just set it up right here. So if you did not want a frame, again, look how pretty that is.
Fair. Easy.
We right? could be done. We're going to take it up a notch.
That is gorgeous.
It
right?
is so pretty. In fact, most of Mark's prints are not framed
that I've noticed.
Oh, you're right. He sells them just on. He sells them when they're mounted. So we're going to frame it because I have, like, I'm very modern farmhouse, I think. Mm-hmm. More modern than farmhouse, a little bit hope. Kelly's very legit farmhouse because she lives in a farmhouse. I live in a tract home, and so I feel like I can't go too farmhousey.
And I bet you save a lot of money ordering the print and framing it yourself. And that wood was probably $2 or $3.
Oh yeah.
So I imagine it's probably a $45 or $50 difference.
Yeah.
I'm guessing. I haven't been on the site yet myself.
Yes.
Okay. So now
I'm gonna show the edges real quick.
Oh yeah. Underneath.
Before, yeah.
There you go. Just the corners.
Here I come.
All right.
All right. So here are your little edges.
We just folded it. Oh, lighting's getting weird. Anyway, you can see we just folded it nice and tight.
And that's like a package. What, 5 minutes maybe?
Yeah.
So now these, Mark also has prints and so on. If you guys want to know Mark, if they don't introduce him. Mark Mabry, I actually know him through one of our best friends growing up. And so he married her sister. But he's also world renowned for his Reflections of Christ series. All right. So these are, like Christy said, we just ripped down her husband. Ripped down this barnwood, these barnwood strips. And he pre-measured them for us, so now it's just like putting together a puzzle.
Yeah. So when you're sign making, we just try to do what fits best. But look how pretty these edges are. Can you guys see that?
So this is from a local Phoenix company called Porter Barnwood.
And I will link to the bedroom.
We'll link to all of this in the comments. I'm sorry, we're not being very interactive. Not nice rack. Oh, thank you. Trying to read those comments.
I honestly just thought you said nice rack.
Oh, I wish. I was not blessed in that department.
I was like, oh, girl.
This is not a sponsored post, but this is hands down my favorite tool. I love it so much. It's a Brad nailer or a Brad gun. They have a couple different names. Super easy to swap out your different nail sizes, and it's cordless, which is my favorite.
I don't think my husband accounted for the camper being wrapped on the edges. I'm like, that's okay.
We'll make it work. Okay. But I love this thing. It's my favorite. This is what I use for all my signs.
And so they're interactive with all the other Ryobi tools, which is nice.
The battery. My sander. I use the two. See, I'm actually going to staple. It's okay. Right. We'll make it work. I'm going to staple. I like to staple close to the edge so I can push the wood down really flat.
So I'll hold this side.
And then I always start in the middle. And you kind of push. The nice thing with that frame, you're not going to dent your canvas. So you just push it down.
And it's really sturdy because that's wood into wood.
And this nail gun is quiet enough to do it.
Sorry, can you hear that?
Indoors. There you go. This side is done.
What it looks like. Show them real quick.
This is what it looks like.
Oh, you guys.
Frame.
You're gonna die. Ready?
Yeah. Does that look so? Look at all the reflections. See what I did there? The different reflections of wood. Oh, we love it.
I believe the word is grains. Different grains.
Okay. So you can also stain it yourself if you just have wood from Home Depot or Lowe's or wherever you just get your wood.
And so on the back side, you can see it's flat. So it's the same height as your, can you see that? The same height.
Yeah.
And so this stuff that we pulled tight, you can't even see.
Yeah. And once you hang it, you won't be able to see it at all.
Okay. So then I like to do the short side next.
Oh, so this way.
Around.
So you can see there's a little bit longer pieces on either side to accommodate for the pieces going on. So this is like basically sign making.
Yes.
So Kelly's just gonna line it up.
So now you can choose what you like. Do you like the black?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna have the black. I guess it's the top. You're not gonna see it much. I'm gonna scoot over a smidge to accommodate for the thickness of the...
I know, we might
have to... You could trim
we
off.
May have to redo that side of the canvas because it's a little bit thicker than the wood that we pre-measured.
When I make my signs, I will... And I guess the same could go for the canvas. I cut my frame afterward.
And I should have done that because I didn't tell my husband.
Well,
no. I had him wrap it according to the wood frame that the canvas would be going on. Not,
you know what?
Not this, with the canvas on
this
it.
Is why it's nice to be a fan of the shabby chic rustic style.
Yeah.
Because you can go, oh, that was intentional.
And I can just take a little piece. I can either recut it or take another piece of wood and
oh,
fill it
true.
In.
That's true. I would just fill it in. It's so small.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I have lots of wood left. No,
maybe we should do. Let's put this in to see. Yeah, you're right. It's just a smidge too short. But that is, again, that's why we're doing it live. So you guys won't mess up because you can go, oh, remember they need to count.
I'm that. Looking at my carpenter husband and he's giving me.
He's like,
he's giving me
it.
A stink eye. It wasn't his fault. I didn't accommodate for the canvas thickness.
You know what? It still looks
amazing.
Awesome.
So we're going to switch it around. Hope you guys like Kelly today because she's a star of the show.
You know, you can come over here and chat with me. Today's St. Patrick's Day. I'm wearing green. Are you?
I have a little bit.
I was going to pinch you. All three of my kids have Irish names. My husband's ancestors are from Ireland. So we made green pancakes.
I made rainbow.
You did.
Are we up?
We're out.
Perfect.
Okay. That's it. Easy. Super lightweight. Oh my.
my gosh, it's so pretty. Wow. It's so pretty.
You guys ready for the
how
reveal?
How do you hang it, Mrs. Jansen?
Oh, how are we gonna hang it?
So the wood on the back is super thick. You still have what was that?
3 inches.
Yeah, 3 inches. And so I'm just going to take regular hardware and hang it. So here it is. You can see the dark tones. I'm gonna pull it up real quick. You can see the dark tones of the contrasting grains with the white print.
So oh, here go. It is, you guys. Does that look pretty? Amazing or what? So Jesus says hello.
And I think this was shot. I know it was shot in South America.
No, it actually wasn't.
It was in the border of Ajo, Arizona. No, I'm going to show you the back side. So you can see how nice and secure this is. I'm going to put it up here so you can see.
Still very lightweight.
But see how like nice and clean those edges are?
Yeah.
So that's it, you guys.
So cute.
We're gonna. We'll squint right now. I'll squint even with my glasses.
Okay.
No, I can pull it.
Get the right, the Ryobi stapler. It's awesome. Okay, thanks.
Oh, sorry. I'm gonna cover this for 2 seconds. Sorry, my hand's in the way. And get closer so we can. Okay. Sorry.
Frame around the piece. Do you?
There we go.
Sides
it was Arizona. Reflections of Crisis on. Reflections of Crisis on our Instagram, and he says. It was Arizona. It was right by the border.
Mark, you did go to South America for something, though. Am I losing it? I swear you did. So,
thanks, Amy. You guys are so sweet.
Hello.
Okay.
You guys have put my frame around the piece. Did you say that?
Yeah. She does what you do.
Oh,
she frames
okay.
it after.
I
so framing it after would avoid teeny little gaps.
Yes. Fawn says, where did you get the canvas? It's from reflectionsofchrist.com.
He's on our Instagram live. We're at Ryobian Blog as well. If you guys want to pop over, Mark Mabry is the artist behind it. His handle is at Reflections of Christ.
I'm going to scoot over so you can
look
see.
How pretty it is.
Let's just stare at all of you guys.
So Mark is actually offering 25% off your canvas if you order before the 22nd at Reflections of Christ or Reflections of Christ.
So I think that's it.
Yeah.
I think we will do a little intro and throw this on YouTube for long lasting. Unfortunately, on our Instagram stories, we don't have the highlight reel because Instagram hates us. We also don't have the shop feature. So
yes.
And thanks for the heart.
If you guys have any questions, you can DM us or email us lollyjane@gmail.
Yeah.
We're on Instagram. All of our social media handle is at lollyjaneblog.
Mm-hmm.
And we are going to do a live at least once a week. Probably leave your comments
and maybe twice.
What day is the best day for you if we do an Instagram live? Is Saturday midday good?
You're doing that. You need this.
Yeah,
because he's hard. It's so fun to watch.
You guys are cute. We love you guys so much. So leave us feedback, what you would like to see or the days that work for you.
Should I have them vote?
We are here to please you.
Yes. I wonder if I should put this picture here in my dining room or over my piano.
Do you guys want to show me your piano?
Yeah,
show
my
piano.
Should we walk over? You guys want to take a little tour?
We have a little janky setup here. We have the phone on top of...
Okay,
the computer. Oh, she's going.
I'm showing you guys. Here's our setup. It's very professional.
She don't show them that stuff.
That's funny. Hey, we're in real life. So I'm going to take you guys too. Everybody come with me. So this is our setup.
But
how messy your house is.
Shut up.
Okay.
I live here. Okay, so here's the piano. I just painted it. It's really grainy in this room. It's dark to see. But if you guys think I should put it over the piano, I have a perfect space for it. Tell me, and if you guys think I should put it over the dining room, yeah, wherever you guys think that would be best suited. But I do love it with this wall. This is wallpaper I did like last month, I think. So anyway, all right, we will let you guys get on with your St. Patrick's Day.
Over the piano for sure. I agree.
Okay.
Tara is gushing over your setup.
Hey, Tara.
Oh, hey, Tara. You guys are so sweet. How big is it? It's about... Roughly it's, 3x4.
Yeah,
my math is terrible. What is that, Mark?
30x44 inches?
Roughly 3x4.
Yeah.
So they have lots of different sizes. I've seen them. If you go to Reflections of Christ Instagram and you hit where they've been tagged.
Mark asked to jump on our...
Guys, we don't do Instagram lives. Go live with Reflections of Christ.
Yeah. So on
there
our Instagram, Mark's going to join us. Oh, 30x40. I was close, Mark.
Annika.
And so there's different sizes. I've seen them 8x10, you can do 5x7s. And so, anyway, you can frame it any size you want. Oh, there they are.
Hey, guys.
You guys, if you're on Facebook, on our Instagram, is the owner.
Hey, Tara.
Is of Reflections of Christ.
Hi.
He's the photographer behind me.
Shut the door.
And his wife is one of our best friends.
I didn't know it was going to be on camera.
Oh, you're on camera, girl.
I have you seen this.
I love the clock behind the canvas. Oh, thank you. That clock, Megan, is actually from Roberts here in Gilbert. They have them in Utah as well. I don't think they have them online, however.
Yeah. Okay, Natalie says behind the piano.
Well, above the piano.
Because behind would be weird.
Okay. So, Mark, do you have anything to add?
Oh. Yeah, I love this.
Oh, that's so beautiful. I love it.
Oh, good. We're good.
Hi.
You guys nailed the frame. I think it's so cool.
Can you go close up on it? I want to see that frame. That's awesome.
Yeah. Isn't it so pretty? We'll do another close up.
Okay, I will say, now that I'm looking at it, look how pretty it looks with like the uneven tones of the wood. Can you see that?
Wait, come over a little more.
Oh, that's so great.
Isn't that pretty?
The knotted.
Yes,
that's awesome.
I love it.
We gotta reframe one.
I don't know if you're gonna go make me frame stuff.
I think you should. Yeah. I think you should offer it on your options and call it the Lolly Jane frame. I mean, that might be cool.
I'm sure Porter
would be
the Lolly Jane frame.
Lolly Jane frame.
You guys wanna go into mass production on your frames?
Done,
right?
So, Facebook, you can't hear what we're saying, but Mark said he's definitely offering a Lolly Jane frame. And he's just releasing that information today. Just kidding. Yeah. Well, I think we're going to let you guys go. Do you have anything to add, Mark and Tara?
No, other than thank you for showing that. I think it's so awesome, and I'm honored. Like, and I vote for Over the Piano.
Okay, that's what I think. That's what Kelly said, too. The lighting was just a little janky in here today, so... We did it here,
that's
but
okay.
I think, yeah, over time was perfect. Yeah. Okay, well, thanks for joining us. Have a happy St. Patrick's
Day. Thank you, guys.
Bye.
Oh, thank you.
See ya.
Okay, all right, I'll let Kelly log off. I'll just sit here, stare at my new picture, how pretty it is.
I actually don't know how to end it.
I don't either.
No, hold on. Bye, you guys.
This is awkward.
All right. End live video. Hold on, Facebook.
All right. Thanks, you guys, for joining us.
Okay, bye, you guys. And
mine had a touch
screen. Yours is not touch screen.
Mine's a Mac.
That's awkward.